Hi, I'm Ryan Gingrich, the behaviorist. Today we're in Hitchcock, Texas, working with Olivia from Habitat for Horses on her pushy behavior. Before we start working with Olivia today, I want to talk to you about a couple of tools we're going to use. The very first tool we're going to talk about is a cue stick. It's a very light, responsive way of communicating with your horse. It's not that fumbly fiberglass rod that you'll find some other trainers using. The second thing is a cotton lead rope. It's a 10-foot cotton lead rope. It's very safe for you and your horse. The third thing I'm going to talk about here and use today is a connection halter. A connection halter is a way of communicating with your horse without pain. You know, you're going to get responsiveness from your horse, and your horse is not going to be reacting to the pressure points on his face. So let's talk about cues. What cues are we going to need to teach Olivia to stop being a pushy horse? One of the very first cues that we're going to use is spot one. Spot one lies about right here. That's going to teach Olivia to go forward. We're also going to need to use spot two, which will lie basically right here in the middle of her ribs. Spot two teaches the horse to go faster when we ask her to. We're also going to be needing spot three, which is going to lie right back here on her where the back cinch would, a western saddle would be. That's going to teach her to move her hips away from me when I ask her to. The other thing we're going to need to be able to teach Olivia, which is going to be very important, is the stop cue. The stop cue starts right here with the lead rope. Okay, I talked about that, the lead rope earlier. That's going to be very important to you. And the reason it's important is because it's going to teach Olivia that when you add pressure to the halter, this connection halter here, that she's going to want to move away from that pressure. All right, these are the cues that we're going to use over and over and over again with Olivia throughout this show. So why do you have a pushy horse? Well, it's always the same old story. You know, pushy horses have no rules, they've known no boundaries, and it's always, you know, the owner's lack of leadership that's caused them to do this. Today I'm going to empower you with the knowledge it takes to stop this potentially dangerous and always annoying behavior. We're going to teach Olivia basic control. Basic control teaches those six basic things all horses need to know how to do. First thing is go. We're going to teach her a go forward cue using spot one and spot two. Then we're going to teach Olivia how to stop when we ask her to. Because right now what Olivia is saying to me is, I don't understand stop. Your stop cue doesn't mean anything to me. So I'm going to push right past that and say, you know what? I don't know any rules. I don't have any boundaries. Your space is my space. It doesn't matter to me. The next thing we're going to do will be teaching Olivia just to move her hips left and right. All right. We'll be teaching her to move her hips over to the left side, move her hips over to the right side. In case, you know, she's in a space that we want her to stay in, we can move her back and forth until we get her to stop. All these things, all these six very fundamental things that we're going to teach Olivia, that is go, stop, turn left, turn right, back up and stand still, that we're going to be talking about today. So you guys stick around. I'll be right back. Have you lost control? Do you wish there was a set of simple steps you could take to regain back the trust you've lost in your horse? Well, there is. It's my Basic Control DVD. This DVD has all the elements necessary for achieving control and gaining back the trust you've lost. Basic Control has six fundamental parts. Each part is designed to give you a better understanding of your horse. I know you've been longing for a special relationship, and here's where it starts. Go to RyanGingrich.com. Get control, gain the trust you desire, and make that special connection. So get my Basic Control DVD now.
Does your horse spook or jump at nearly everything? Stop that spooky, nervous behavior today. Teach your horse to be calm and quiet and get back in the saddle safely again. Horse expert Ryan Gingrich offers real help with proven results. Equine expert Ryan Gingrich has traveled the nation helping thousands of spooky horses. Help for you and your horse is just a phone call away. Order now by calling 800-359-4090 or by going online to RyanGingrich.com. Stop your horse from bucking now. Stop the bucking and start riding again. Equine behavior expert Ryan Gingrich has the solution. His two DVD set contains over 2 hours of easy to follow proven methods. Train your horse at home today. Order now and get Ryan's two bucking DVDs jam-packed with over 2 hours of proven training methods to stop bucking. Plus, if you order right now, we'll give you a 1 month membership to Ryan's Connection Club absolutely free. But wait, that's not all. We will also send you a bonus 1 hour training DVD. Order the Stop Bucking DVD right now. You'll get 2 hours of training instruction on two DVDs, a free membership to the Connection Club, and a bonus DVD free. That's three DVDs worth over $100, a free one-month club membership, all for only $29.99. Call now or go online to order at RyanGingrich.com. Call or go online now.
Welcome back. I'm back here with Olivia, and we're working on basic control with Olivia. And the very first thing we're going to talk about is go forward. And we're going to teach the go forward cue from the side of her body here, right where that girth line starts. Now, if you watch Olivia's body here, anytime I bring the cue stick up to her body, she's going to go ahead and flinch and maybe move around a little bit. I don't want to see that in her. That's not a reaction. Excuse me. That's not a responsiveness to the cue stick. That's a reaction to it. All right. So what I would do at that point, I would basically desensitize her to this movement of the cue stick next to her body. All right, saying this doesn't mean anything to you. This shouldn't mean anything to you. Only thing I'm going to ask you to do is when I tap you to go forward, okay, that you go forward with the correct leg. The correct leg is the inside leg. All right. So once I've done that a little bit, you know, I've really desensitized her to that whip, then I'm going to say, all right, go forward. Oh, she gave me the wrong leg. Now, I'm always going to be using what I also call deletion, right? So I'm going to be deleting that response, set you up for success, say, come on forward. Good girl. Once we got the horse going forward like we're asking her to, I'm going to ask her to stop. Now, the very stop is important to Olivia because she doesn't know how to stop. The pressure on the halter, the nose pressure that comes on that halter, doesn't mean anything to her. It just means that it's just pressure, okay? You know, no different than me coming up to you and pushing you in the back, all right? Kind of rude. All right, to Olivia, that's kind of rude. So she says, hey, I'm gonna resist that pressure. I'm gonna push right through it. So at that point, I say, I've already had my go cue worked out. You know, we worked on go forward. We're working forward here, all right? Now I'm gonna take my hand, place it closer to her chest, and say to Olivia, stop your feet, all right? When I say stop your feet, I want her feet to stop or move backwards at that point. Okay, so go forward. Good girl. Hand closer to the chest. Stop her feet. She's kind of resistant there. I'm going to add more pressure, all right? We're talking about that pressure scale, 1 to 10. 1 being very little pressure, 10 being the most pressure it takes to get the job done, all right? A little bit of pressure there. Good girl. Ask her to back up a couple steps. And the back is nothing more than an extension of the stop cue, all right? Go forward. Now, if you guys have watched my show and for the past several years, you guys have seen this before, so I'm not going to dwell on this. And again, you can find this in my basic control DVD and something that you guys really need to be very cognizant about your horses and how well do they do this, because it's so very important to the overall success of your horse. All right, once we got this down and the horse is really doing something well, all right, then what we're going to do, doing this well, doing going forward and backing up, we're going to do a circle off the rail. What I'm going to do is just basically ask her to orbit around me in a circle, okay? And a lot of times they're going to do just what she did there, and that's stop her feet. And the reason I do this with a pushy horse, because they're going to do just what she just did there, all right? That's bolt right past me.